Fleck live from Rio, where we are still joined by Johnny Vegas, who seems to have developed his own exercise regime with a pair of Australian Speedos.
Mate, this is like an infomercial. The Thighmaster. Not only is it portable, you can wear it under your trousers for work. Anyway, who doesn't need that 10 minutes where you're going, if only I could work on my legs more? As being a fat child, you know what I mean, I've been scoffed by people. Had I only been given this as a youth, it's going to be very, very different.
All right, we need to bring out our first last leg medalist for 2016. Earlier today, she won a silver in the long jump. It's Steph Reid. Let's see what you did to get the medal. Steph in action earlier today. This, at the time, was a Paralympic record?
Reid's on her way. Last jump. Hits the board well. Puts out a good one.
That is a silver medal winning jump, ladies and gentlemen. And the first medal live in the studio that has been won. There it is. Can we listen to it? Because it has a jingle, doesn't it? Now, so you set, was it a Paralympic record you set in your first jump?
I think so, yes.
Yes, yeah, I think so. It was.
Yeah, no, it's the kind of thing I just did this morning. It's fine.
At that point, did you think you had it in the bag, or were you worried that someone...
Definitely not. I had a huge jump this year, and I was actually only about a four centimeter difference between myself and Marie all along. But it was a brilliant competition, because actually, fourth place this year would have won in London 2012.
Wow.
So it's come on huge, and I knew it would be a fight, and, you know, Marie jumped, an awesome jump, so good for her.
Well, Jane Mitchell said, is it okay that Paralympic medal winners get given a small model of Josh Widdicombe with their medals?
Yeah, it's branding. Can I?
Yeah.
That doesn't look like me, does it? We should just sit that there and I'll talk from off stage and people will tune in and go, what the hell has happened?
It got really old. Let's check up on the medal table. Everyone keeps tweeting me about Australia and Great Britain. There it is. Great Britain second with 6 golds. Australia, 13th for the position.
Oh, what a shame.
They've had to actually do something special so that you fit on the page.
Oh, stop it. Steph, you've been training incredibly
hard. You're so far down, you're actually on Channel 5.
You've been training so hard, and of course, when you're training, there are certain foods you're not allowed to have. You've now finished competing. What is it that you most want to eat?
Oh, chocolate cake.
Chocolate cake? Thankfully, that's what we've got. We had a feeling we have... If you'd like to bring it out, please, Mark. Oh. This.
Oh.
Wow.
Do I get any?
No, Alex, no.
Why?
Because it's for Steph.
Okay.
It's her birthday. When you come on with
have
a silver medal...
Have you been following why she's on here?
When you come on with a silver medal, you can have chocolate cake.
It was my birthday 4 days ago.
Do you want a strawberry?
One thing that...
Really? That's all you're going to offer me, the strawberry. Wow.
I've been interested to ask you if you've got any tips. Because in your line of work, like, I got sand in my prosthetic on the beach the other day. It must be a nightmare. Like, have you got any... Because I've shaken it. I just can't get it out.
It's just everywhere. You just have to grow to love it.
Grow to love it?
Have you tried hoovering it out with a Henry?
With a Henry? I didn't bring a Henry on holiday with me. I've got 3 legs, man.
What's hand luggage in itself?
Well, yeah, there's a question, because you've got 3 legs.
Yeah, it was amazing this morning.
Well, this is news to me.
This is the most prosthetic legs I've ever had, because I've got the blade, the hairy one, and my other, like, my everyday one.
Yeah.
So I looked up this morning, I kind of, the blade...
The one?
It's one with hair on it. Right. I've got the blade and the hairy...
Self-explanatory.
The blade and the hairy one were on the shelf, and I was just like, it's the first time I've ever been like, oh, what to wear?
You've got 6, haven't you?
I do, 6. Yes. I have a variety of blades.
Yeah.
I have a high heel leg, which they asked, do you want hair on this? I said, no.
You should have gone really hairy. It would have been amazing.
And I have my daily leg that I walk in.
Isn't there one that you had? You wanted it made to look exactly like your other leg, so the person gave you a yellow toenail?
Yes. Well, they said, you want it to look exact, and I said yes, and I thought, oh, actually, I'd like it a little bit nicer.
So did you just do one a day, and then Sunday you just put your feet up literally?
Oh, what was the
oh,
thing?
Oh, come when, on!
When you went for a pedicure, and they wouldn't do it for half price.
Yes, but see, my mum is an accountant, and so obviously you have one foot, it's half the time, it's half the product. I thought it was a pretty reasonable request.
Yeah.
They said no. And so I was kind of thrown, and I just thought, you know, I really need this pedicure. And so I said, fine, you know, I'll pay full price, but everything you do to my real foot, I'm going to need you to do to my artificial foot.
All of your artificial foots have gone. Have fun.
Now, tonight is going to be one of the most exciting nights of the Games as Johnny Peacock races for gold again in the glamour event, the 100-metre sprint. He already set a Paralympic record yesterday in his heat, which looked like this.
Peacock is away, and it's really motoring down the straight. He's pushing out here, trying to make a bit of a moment of intent.
And Paralympic record and eased off over the last couple of metres. You can see him race at 11:58 p.m. tonight, but before he came out to Rio, Josh and I sat down with him for a quick two-on-one interview.
It's going to be Peacock! Peacock takes the ball from Great Britain! Peacock wins in a time of 10.9 seconds!
Johnny Peacock, hello.
Afternoon.
Hello. Now, I'm going to ask you what we've asked everybody else. Where would you like the interview to be?
Nando's.
We could make it a high street chicken train.
Some form of chicken shop.
A nondescript high street chicken shop.
That'll do.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Done.
Yeah, I love it. It's great.
And is that what you're looking forward to at the end of all this? At the end of all this training and the competing, just going and having a greasy, dirty meal?
Oh, yeah, I have that every day anyway.
Also, they're not greasy, they are flame grilled.
Yeah, that's to say, yeah, to be fair, yeah. A big burger is what I'll be looking for after.
Now, listen, I've got some questions for you, and we've covered this ground before, that you are one of the few people that I've met, especially the only person I've met who's an athlete who has a similar kind of prosthetic to me.
Yeah, you've got a longer one than me.
I've got a longer prosthetic?
Oh, we're talking about, yeah, Leah, you've got a longer stump too.
I have got a longer stump, that's right. That's right. I mean, but it's not how big your stump is.
No, exactly. It's how you use it.
Exactly. So, but I've recently been fitted with a blade, and you run with a blade.
Yeah.
So when you've been running on a blade, and then you go back to your day leg, does it feel weird, because the blade's so springy, to then put your other leg back on again?
Yeah. I think at the beginning, maybe. But, you know, you get used to it. So right. For me, I'm much more comfortable in my day leg. You know, I like my day leg. My blade is set up for me to be optimal at sprinting. So obviously walking around back from reps and stuff, it's not the most comfortable thing in the world.
Now, we have talked about this on the show before, when you've been on the show, is that one of your butt cheeks is a lot firmer than the other. And it comes from racing, it comes from one, you know, glute.
I've improved. My gluteus has improved since you last.
Well, that's what I'm
wondering. Does that mean they're more different?
They should be even more cushiony.
Well, Josh tested last time.
Okay.
And I'm going to do a bit of a blind test, if you just want
to
put
this
on.
Okay, well, this is the most degrading thing that any of us have ever done, but let's get on with it. Can I have my first pair of buttocks, please? Okay. I'm not sure they're meant to describe like I'm on food and drink. And I'm, okay, I've had them. Can I have my second? They were good, don't get me wrong, they were good, but I'm thinking that's Hills's, because... Ready? Here we go. Oh, my word. Oh, my word. I mean, that is 24 carat peacock, that is. I mean, Adam, yeah. I haven't got a problem with yours, but when you're competing with the best, they felt symmetrical as well, Johnny. I don't know whether...
Did you think?
Yeah, I don't know whether that's a
I'm
good
I'm happy
or
with that.
You're happy with that?
I'm happy with that. If you're pleased with my buttocks, then I think I can leave a happy man.
Well, I think that's the best way to end the interview, isn't it?
Johnny, good
Thanks
luck.
For having
Thank
me.
You very much. Thank Cheers.
As we meet a Zimbabwean team of battlers in a boat, plus we do want to know, how should we honour Sarah's story next? Tweet us at The Last Leg, use the hashtag StoryGlory. We'll see you soon. Leg Live from Rio, where we are still joined by Johnny Vegas, who seems to have developed his own exercise regime with a pair of Australian Speedos.
Mate, this is like an infomercial. The Thighmaster. Not only is it portable, you can wear it under your trousers for work. Anyway, who doesn't need that 10 minutes where you're going, if only I could work on my legs more? As being a fat child, you know what I mean, I've been scoffed by people. Had I only been given this as a youth, it's going to be very, very different.
All right, we need to bring out our first last leg medalist of 2016. Earlier today, she won a silver in the long jump. It's Steph Reed.